When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
My scoop is here, or my turd technicians at Scoopy Doo. They're all special in this, in their own unique way. When I say special, I really mean special. Hey, did you wipe your feet?
Nope.
Come on.
It's just a little shit. Here's my sheets, Kevin.
Did you do what I asked?
That's right.
Whoa. Mike.
Yeah?
Where are the number of buckets?
Weren't
you supposed to put the buckets that you take out of every house on here?
Probably.
Why didn't you do it?
I didn't have a pen.
You didn't have a pen?
No.
Mike, I gave you like 6 pens the other day.
The trunk is like an abyss.
Oh, come on!
Poof, it disappeared.
How am I gonna know how to charge these guys?
Just put 2 for each house. Just make up some numbers.
Mike, you're killing me. Oh my god.
What's the problem?
Hey, where were you last weekend? You went to NASCAR?
Yeah, I was at the race in Dover.
Yeah, how was it?
It was loud. Very loud.
More important, what'd you eat?
The night before.
What he ate!
This is
I like to know what he eats. We talk the same language
over
here.
Tell me how to pen and write that down with.
This is
enough with the pen.
The night before I made sergeant peppers, I grilled the peppers and peppers and onions and made in a pan. And I cut up a big Italian hero and stuffed them all inside.
Nice.
And then I melted cheese on top so it all stayed together.
Oh, beautiful. It's like the glue.
Yeah, because then you don't want the sandwich like falling apart when it's in the cooler.
Oh, nice.
I'll see you tomorrow or something.
Don't lock the keys in the car. Knock off the bumper. And make sure it's clean.
Alright, I'll do most of those things.
What do you want me to do with this?
Leave the guy alone. Everybody we got here is a little special.
But, Jim, look. I wrote on here, number of buckets. Do you see it?
You go through the same thing every day.
But I don't know how to charge these people. Then it comes back on my shoulders. They call you. You're saying, what does it say? And I'm like,
what do you want me to tell you?
It doesn't have anything on here. I made up a number.
He's a good guy. He tried.
You got to
leave him alone. He's a mopper.
This is ridiculous.
We speak the same language. Take it easy. I'll handle it.
Jim, where are you? You in the toilet?
I'm over here, jackass.
Listen, I can't drive this truck anymore.
Come on, you gotta give me aggravation. I'm over here, all relaxed.
Stunk the truck up. I don't even know what it is.
Who?
If it's not dog crap, Ramskill.
Which truck?
The purple truck. It stinks to high hell.
How bad does it stink?
You go out there and you sit in it for 5 hours and see if you can drive it. It stinks like garlic and tobacco and dog poop. A whole combination, all thrown in together like a mixed salad.
I think you're overreacting.
It's ridiculous. You want to go sit in that truck or come with me to the dump? You can
go to the dump, come back, whatever. I'll talk to Ramskill tomorrow.
Yeah, no more smoking in the truck. I don't even want him in the
truck.
I told
him
if he's
going
to be in that truck, I want nothing to do with the truck. I want my own truck.
I got Kathy breaking my balls, and now I got you breaking my
balls. And I'm going to keep breaking your balls. I want my own truck. Enough with this guy. He jumps in the truck and ruins it for me.
I'll talk to him.
I'm out of here.
All right. Pain in the ass. Freaking guy. Ramskill!
Hey.
What's up?
Not much.
Hey, did you get the truck done?
Truck is all set. Oil change, tires, alignment, brakes adjust. Rides nice.
Hey, we got a little bit of a problem, man. The guys are breaking my balls that the truck stinks again. Did you clean the inside of the truck?
Nothing in there.
They said it's rotten. They don't want to use the truck.
I keep that thing clean as a whistle. You
are you
that.
Sure?
Absolutely.
Where is it? I want to inspect it.
Right out front.
Let me take a sniffski.
Hey,
Hey, don't look bad with the new tires.
Yeah, rides nice.
Little purple haze.
No, I don't know, it's got a little funk in there.
Yeah, it's pretty funky. It's a bit worse. They're all complaining, man. They're breaking my balls.
What do you expect? I'm shoveling shit all day. What do you want it to smell like?
It smells like money.
We like that.
Tell you about this guy, Sean Brown. Years ago, he came to me when I first started Scoopy Doo. He wanted to buy it from me. Sean's a good guy. He has laundromats. He has this and that. You know, he's a true entrepreneur, so him and I hit it off right from the get-go. So he really wanted to buy my business, and I said, I'm not interested in selling it because I love the dog poop business. My wife would say I'm stupid, but I said, you know, I'll help you out. You want to get started in Queens, because that's where he was from, and at the time I wasn't interested in going to Queens. So I helped him with the ropes, showed him how to do this, showed him how to do that, and you know what? Years later, it turns out, it turned around and came and bite me right in the butt. Oh, Mr. Brown. What's up, brother?
Not much, brother.
How's things?
Rolling, man.
How's the kids?
Everybody's good. How's yours?
Yeah, any vacations coming up?
This week.
Yeah, you bastard.
Yeah.
Hey, the reason I called you in here is these guys, all my guys, are seeing your guys creeping closer and closer and closer over here again. Come on, we got to keep it in Queens. We got to keep the boundaries together. You know you're not supposed to be in my backyard.
But I get calls and you're not going.
Yeah, oh, you know I'm going over there. Come on. You got to keep it a friendly competition over here. You can't start creeping in.
Yeah,
you know the boundaries.
When you got people calling the office, what should I do?
Come on, sure.
What should I do?
I see him over there in the south. Sure, he's coming into Nassau. He was over here at my back door the other day.
Popular in the area. People keep calling me. What do you want me to do?
You're more popular in the poop world than me? I don't think so.
Everybody loves me. They say, I don't want to use that other guy. I want to use you.
You're full of shit. They never say that.
All the time. I record it.
Never happened. Never happened. You keep creeping. Something's got to give, man. A handshake is a handshake.
I don't mind shaking your hand, Jim. We can shake hands all day, but I still
got
to make
money. I'm telling you about this. I'm telling you about the trucks. Next thing I know, you got the same truck as me. Not only you have the same truck as me, would you go to the same guy that does the letters? He did the exact same letters on the truck.
I got a copy of you. It's letters on the truck. All letters look the same.
It's the same truck.
About? You got a dog with a shovel. I got a dog with a badge.
The only thing that is different is the color. Well, for example, remember I was telling you about I was going to do, we're opening up next door, and I was going to do a pet taxi to the Hamptons. Next thing I know, a girl comes in, look, Poop Patrol, your thing, and it says we now offer pet taxis. What the hell is that?
How many dogs can you take care of? How many people can you have? You have enough. Let me have
but
something.
But you understand, this is my area over here. But and that was the agreement.
But you make up your area. Your area keeps growing.
No, my area has always been here. Your area has been Queens going in west.
I don't see you busting that other guy chops.
Who, Chris?
Chris.
Poopy, I had to sit down with him last week. He's starting to creep. Everybody plays cute until they get caught. You know how many accounts I gave that guy this year? I must have given him 100 accounts.
Well, I tell you what. You give me 100 accounts, you never have to see me again.
You better behave or I'm going to put the Italian hex on you. And you want no part of that. Mr. Brown.
No.
All right, be good.
All right.
Stick to your word.
Gotta go.
I think this guy needs a little bit of a lesson. Corwin.
Yo.
We got a little bit of a situation.
Don't talk on the phone. It's not safe. I'll be right down.
Okay. Clear.
Clear.
And let me tell you a little bit about the Corwinator. This is like a little crazy guy I know for many years, but he, you know, when I envision these ideas, he comes up with it. He's always on target. I come up with the idea, boom, he bangs it right out. He's been known to go over and above. When I need some special operations taken care of, he comes right out, and he's right in here. He's undercover is what he does best.
What's
Corwin.
Up, Jim? How are you?
What do you got for me?
I got something special for you. The Immobilizer 5000.
Beautiful. What does it do?
This place ain't bugged, is it?
Hey, you better take it easy a little bit, man. You're a little hyper today. No. You stop smoking again?
Yeah. I got a patch on each arm, though.
You're chewing two packs of Nicorette again? Take it easy a little bit.
Check,
all right, let me see what you got.
Check this out. This little doohickey, We're going to put it under the frame, sticks right on his frame like that, and stay there.
Oh, that's beautiful.
This is the remote. From 1,000 feet away, I hit this button, he won't be able to start it for a half an hour.
Nice!
But if I hold this button down too long, it can burn up his whole wiring harness.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't do that. I don't want to burn anything up. I just want to scare him a little bit, delay him.
It would probably start in like a half an hour.
That's good. Perfect. Let him stall. By the time he calls a tow truck, it'll start up. It'll slow him down a little bit. Got to teach him a little bit of a lesson. Corwinator.
Yeah, Jim.
Yeah, what's up?
The eagle has landed.
What?
The eggs are in the basket.
What the hell are you talking about?
The rooster is in the barn. Don't you speak English?
What the hell are you trying to say?
There's fuel on the fire.
What are you trying to tell me? You saw Bob Marley?
Affirmative. The situation is fluid.
Beautiful. Well, you know what you gotta do.
10-4.
Okay. We got something for you. You hit the button. Button over here.
Oh shit, the button stuck. Oh damn, the button stuck. Holy shit, it's smoking. But I think we burnt this harness. The Corwinator always hits his mark, but this time, I hit this one a little too hard. Jimmy's gonna kill me.
Hello, Scoopy Doo.
Hey, what up, Jim?
Who's this, Brown?
Yeah, it's Brown, man. Let me ask you a question. You know that little truck that I got?
What, the truck you copied from me?
Yeah, whatever. Listen, it's you ever had a problem with smoking?
No, from where?
From like the bottom, like the wiring harness is on fire. Smoking like crazy.
The wiring harness is on fire?
Yeah, smoking like crazy. You never had that happen to any of your trucks?
No, I never had that happen.
I don't know.
I don't know. That's out of warranty, too.
Yeah, no way. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, that sucks.
Stop fighting.
I don't know, man. Good luck with that. Hey, the hex. I didn't realize it was that powerful. What are you going to do?